A couple of restaurants this week get busted for not following the health rules in the kitchen.
Yeah, one of them is warned to throw away food that could get people sick. Get ready for the good, the bad, and the dirty dining as we reveal what's not on the menu in this week's Food for Thought.
Maria's Carnitas on 221 South 16th Street in McAllen may be on the low performer list.
How would you categorize it?
It was kind of high.
But it sure is refreshing to hear third generation owner Maria Sanchez own up to the restaurant's mistakes.
We learn by our mistakes.
Maria scored 23 demerits on its last inspection, missing labels on food in the fridge, bare hand contact on ready-to-eat food, raw meat cut next to hot-hold foods, a cross-contamination no-no, and expired food handler city certifications for a number of employees as well. Typically, restaurants who fail to keep it clean fail to be forthcoming about the problems with the food patrol. Maria's isn't that way. The owner says her customers deserve the best at all times.
We always, you know, try our best. We took our classes and everything, and our employees took our classes, and we don't want nobody, you know, to get sick on our food, you know, so we try our best to keep everything good.
J&J's restaurant on 6332 South 23rd Street in McAllen isn't keeping it clean. 26 demerits turn up on its last health inspection report. An inspector finds improper thawing of food, no hair restraint on a food handler, missing food labels in the fridge, missing paper towels for proper sanitation, and a hot water regulation concern. The food patrol is here to ask one question.
We just want to see if anybody here wants to say if things have been cleaned up since the inspection report.
The manager isn't around for an answer. A peek around shows cleaning in action. Kiki's on 1702 Highway 100 in Port Isabel is the dirtiest this week on Food for Thought. 36 demerits pile up on Monday's checkup. Not on the menu. Eggs left out at room temperature, their order thrown away. Inadequate ham washing. Improper employee hygiene practices. Improper handling of ready-to-eat foods along with cross-contamination concerns. This inspector note reads flies are in the kitchen. The next day, the restaurant is given the all clear on a re-inspection. Panda Express on West Lincoln in Harlingen is this week's featured top performer with zero demerits. The Food Patrol congratulates staff with a sticker. Rudy Ibarra talks about what it should symbolize for everyone.
Cleanliness means, like, just what you see back here. Our guys working, doing their job, and doing what they got to do. Just right here. Polish, do everything we got to do.
The epitome of success.
Yes.
Right. Thank you for keeping it clean, man.
Yes, sir.
Awesome job.
You know what the Food Patrol says to that.
Keep it clean.
And congratulations to these additional top performer sticker winners, Taqueria Jalisco, Americas, and McDonald's on South 77 in Harlingen, Khan's Grill on Nolana in McAllen.
All right, you're all getting a sticker. Remember, kitchens, keep it clean. We're reporting what's not on the menu. Remember, Food Patrol fans, you have a place to share your restaurant experiences with everybody else valley-wide. Join me on my Facebook page. Post a picture. Share what you saw so that others can be warned. To find me on Facebook, Twitter, and Instagram, just search Ryan Wolf.